styled as the best for dining, and it's nowhere to be any Griffin. Now, first up today, it's official. The best county in Ireland for Ascension has been revealed. Drum roll, please. And the winning place goes to Galway. According to a survey by juries, in Galway was picked as the best for the sesh, while Galwegians were also voted the most fun people to hang out with. Elsewhere, Kerry received the most beautiful scenery. Corkonians, isn't that Stephanie, were the best guests. And Dublin was awarded the top shopping destination as well as the best for dining out. So you've been across Limerick's nowhere to be found there, Mairead.
Unfortunately, Limerick is called P&T County when it comes to tourism.
P&T.
People stop for a pee and have a cup of tea and keep moving.
I haven't heard of that.
So they keep moving to Wexford or West Cork and Clare and Kerry and places like that. So, you know, everybody stops in a dare. They go for a pee, have a cup of tea, walk around the place, and then head for the south.
Is Bunratty not in Limerick? Where's the Clare?
Bunratty's in Clare, yes. Oh, yeah. But there's, you know, there's fabulous stuff going on, but my personal favourite would be Lupeg over in Clare.
Yeah.
I think it's absolutely fabulous.
It's not near.
No, but it's in Clare, and it's a gorgeous place.
Yeah. It's a Crescent shopping centre, isn't the bad spot.
Oh, actually, my brother went there for his community.
Great tea came out.
They have, yeah. There's another one out there, Castle Troy.
Yeah.
A couple of TK Maxx, yeah.
It is a bad state of affairs also.
It's taken over,
tourist attraction.
Yeah.
And of course, Corkonians, the best guests.
It is a very good museum in Limerick City. Really good, the whole museum.
Okay, Limerick's over now. You've got your Cork messed up.
Right, here we go.
But it's 16% Cork. That's not a majority.
Well, it's not, the more it's so percentage-wise than anywhere else, though.
But that's not very...
Okay,
grand. Why are we great guests? Because we're...
I'm a great guest on your show, right?
Yeah, but of course. But I don't know what is it that we're polite and the crack?
Maybe we pay.
We give tips.
Well, tips,
that could be it.
Yeah, I was down in Cork recently, invited down by, RSVP, but it was a fantastic night. And I met...
They're a mad person.
I met lovely women. Absolutely amazing women down there, so I thoroughly enjoyed. I was out to all hours of the night, so it was.
See, that's the.
They are friendly folk.
Yeah. Very friendly.
But best for the session is Galway. Who's actually been on the session Galway?
No.
You don't know.
I have been on the session Galway.
No crack.
I don't like crowds or loud noises, so really Galway is pretty offensive to my senses.
But going to university in Galway, people never forget it. I mean, it's a life experience.
Oh, they do forget.
No, but they keep going back. You know, it's a city that there's very great loyalty to.
Yeah,
there's a great last year in July. It's a year ago nearly, and the Film Fla, amazing fun in Galway.
It's like Sodom and Gomorrah from what I hear. I'm afraid to go to Galway for the Film Fla because people come back in a jocker.
Well,
I went there
bed.
2 hours to do an event and then I was gone.
There's bodies everywhere.
People, yes. And crowds and loud noises and questions that couldn't go.
Yeah, so
and that's now, and you're only in your 20s. Where do you hit your 50s or your 60s or your
70s?
Twice as many people in the country.
I kind of came out of the womb hating people.
Really?
Yeah. Right.
We're lucky to have her here at all, to be right honest. Yeah, so that's it. The best place in Ireland, if you like it or not. Dublin, you can shop in, and that's about the size of it now. To work, to live, or live to work. Well, Gabe Byrne opened up about his life on the Radar RC show during the week. He spoke about his cancer treatment and his family. However, when it came to his career, he reveals that he had regrets that he didn't allow himself to take more time off to be around his loved ones. So, when it comes to our jobs, do we just spend too much time behind our desks? Well, we asked you at home.
I think everybody at an age that I imagine, if they've spent too much time working, they always regret it.
I do think so. People should enjoy themselves more. I think they should go to work, of course, but not spend too much time there.
I think people don't realise life just goes by so quickly. You need to, there's precious days, and everybody as well. You should enjoy your family if you can, and try and get a nice balance.
The Irish people are known as good grafters, you know, and some of us work like 70 or 80 hours a week, you know what I mean, which is mad, you know. We should have more time with our families, big time, you know.
Very definitely more work nowadays, and I think it's really a case of necessity, both the mother and father's working with the high mortgages and that. But yes, I totally agree with Gay. We need to take time to smell the flowers because the years slip away very fast.
Well, I think my generation has spent more time in work. There'll be more social hours. People now seem to work. And I'm really working out to play the church. We're all the time. young people now still be, you know, more than at the moment.
He's matching your shirt there, Annie, today. That lovely gentleman. Anyway, regrets.
Oh my God.
I could be singing my way now. Don't! I shouldn't have said that. But it is, I mean, you're just saying they're doing the box tops and everyone's going to have some sort of regret if they approach the end of their life.
Yeah, like you're either going to regret not spending time with your family or you're going to regret not achieving the goals that you set, like the career pinnacle that you set for yourself or that you envisioned for yourself. But that's not going to, like I sometimes say, oh, I'm going to regret at the end of my life not spending more time with my family. So I try to spend more time with my family, and then like 2 o'clock, I'm like, oh, lads, I'm gonna have to get out of here, like, you know.
That's very true.
It's lovely to look back and be like, I should have.
It's when you're in it, it's like, terrible. Yeah.
And then we come to Christmas, and people are like, here are 10 ways to get on with your family, or to, you know, survive the Christmas with
exactly
your family.
Exactly, one day in the year.
Or not harder than Christmas is a great achievement for anybody, really, right?
Well, that's true, but I mean, people talk about, you know, you're not spending enough time at work, or you're spending too much time at work. But I mean, what about the time you spend in front of the telly? Or walking because you're trying to get a few pounds off? Yeah. Like, that's more the kind of time that I might regret. And I think, you know, in terms of career and all the rest of it, I think that starts to hit people in their 40s and 50s, not in their 70s or 80s or their 90s. People seem to be more content with their life at that stage. They have come to terms with whatever, you know, regrets they might have had, and they're able to deal with it. But I think the whole thing about career, and you're not going to be the MD, or you're not going to be whatever you were, you think, you know, post laureate or something like that, it's not going to happen for you.
I think your regret, the thing is that you don't do instead of the things you do. I didn't particularly enjoy doing a parachute jump or jumping out of a plane, but if I didn't do it, I probably would have regretted not doing it.
I've never regretted
it. You're welcome to it.
I actually recently made a bucket list of things that I'm never going to do. Okay, and it really alleviates my anxiety.
Great.
Yeah, like I know that I never have to like backpack across Europe. Not something I want to do. Mm-hmm. Don't want to walk the Camino. Don't want to like jump out of a plane. Don't want to go to a festival. And I have them on my list. And it's like, no, sorry, I have a bucket list of things I'm not going to do, and that's one of them.
Anything more normal and pedestrian?
Oh, like, what do you mean?
Like, apart from jumping out of a plane, is there any like normal everyday activities you're doing?
Well, sure, half the country is walking the Camino.
I know.
Yeah, but back to regrets. I mean, like, it's only when you get into like real middle age and to, or the youth of old age, that you suddenly look back on your life and suddenly realize. Well, it is in essence. But you know what I think? I think life now, because I'm in my 50s, I think I'm now coming into my third act. And if you think about it, a lot happens in the third act. I think the great things can happen in the third act off a play or anything. So I think writing, everybody seems to write each other off like at a certain age.
Yeah.
You're too old to do something. Well, you're never too old, but you've got to be clear about what you want to do.
And you might want to be a plot point too at this stage, because you've been another 40 years, people are living longer, so maybe.
Oh, my father's 90, believe me, I know. There's longevity in the family.
There are
a good chance.
Five act structures, which I work in. So if you're only in the third act, you have two more acts to go.
Yeah
I think that. This part of, you know, when you talk about, like, we talk about meditation and we talk about mindfulness, it's all about staying in the present. If you start looking back over your years, I mean, there's definitely going to be stuff you're going to regret. Looking back over the last day, there's things that I regret. Generally, just keep in the moment.
But it's very hard to keep in the moment if you're a terrible warrior.
Especially when someone in an interview asks.
It's hindsight is a wonderful thing in life, isn't it? Like,
we all had
a crystal ball.
Yeah.
But I suppose it's just you look back and you say, oh, you're getting nearer to the end. Let's be real. Like, you don't know when the end is, but I suppose that's when you start looking back and thinking, like, because I had one child, I mean, maybe I should say I would have loved to have two children, but that was the way things like panned out. So it's all those kind of things.
So, yeah,
you know, wish
worry.
I got married.
It's easier getting
whatever.
Older if you have kids and you can see the kind of progression and the natural rhythms of life. As
no, because you worry about it the same as the word 2-year-old.
Really?
Oh yeah.
Even
Perfect Richard. Yeah, you worry about, you know, his career and not getting, you know, a nice life partner.
God love his poor life partner, and she goes,
yeah,
see, that's like,
you know, I have a granddaughter now, and she's only 8 months old, and today was her very first day in creche. So it's like the
excitement.
Well, no, it's literally like the secret of sending her off to university, you know. Just in terms of the excitement in the family, like, how is she going to cope for her first hour away from her parents? She was great, she didn't even look up when they came in.
So,
I also have a sister who is retiring today from her teaching job. And she says she's not retiring from work or from working. She's just retiring from teaching.
Yeah.
But there's loads of other stuff going to be going on in her life.
Yeah, but this is it. There's loads that you have to still do.
But there are kind of jobs, if you're in the civil service, if you're a teacher, if you're a nurse, if you're a guard, you have your retirement age and that's it.
Mm.
But for most people who are either working or in some of your business or they're self-employed, like, there ain't no retirement age for a step really, is there?
But like, again, what if I'm going to retire, what am I going to do all day? Like, just
meditate.
No, I can't even do that for 30 seconds in the morning.
But
like,
you will do it.
But you can't sit still, can you?
I can't sit still. I hate being idle. I'm always like, oh, there's so many things to think about and write down, and I want to do this, and I want to make that. And
but do you think that's just the stage you're at, though? Do you think in 10 or 20 years you might chill out a small bit?
Come back to me then, that's
yeah.
But I'll be busy that day, though.
Yeah. My dad is 90, and he had a celebratory birthday there, a surprise birthday going back a few months ago, and it was one of the best parties I've ever been at. And he's involved in two choirs. The golf choir, doesn't play golf anymore, and the church choir, and then he takes handicapped people into a swimming pool. He still swims with these amazing people. It was just, he is so busy. He is incredible. At 90 years of age.
But sometimes I think it's your mindset is not actually.
It's
nothing to do with
your physical age. It's
the age
of your chronological age and your mental age can be totally different.
Yeah.
There are 50-year-olds going on 19.
Yes.
90-year-olds going on 50.
Yeah. I would agree with you.
Or 19-year-olds for that matter, who think they're.
Yeah,
like nearly washed up.
Yeah, your nan is quite youthful, isn't she? In her attitude, she's a teenager, basically.
She's just great. She's got a great attitude to life, and it's all about keeping it in the day. We'll deal with that tomorrow.
I know, but you say it's only the moment, I suppose. That's what we have. It's guaranteed.
And I oscillate from like 90 years old to like 4. To like,
it'll all happen.
Yeah, you're ever going to be at the happy medium anywhere between that?
I don't think
tweens,
be happy
teenagers.
Anything, no.
Have you any other way now? We'll take a quick break when we come back. With Bloomsday taking place in just a few weeks, we'll be joined by Senator David Norris after the break. That's in 3.